Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Kitab al-ilm, Sahih al-Bukhari. Hadith number 48-52. Babu ismi man kadaba ala nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Babu. Chapter. The sin of a person who tells a lie against the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Against nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ismu means?
Sin.
Sin. Ismu, if it is sin, ismu.
Name.
Name, Masmuk. Like that. Huh? What's your name? Babu ismi man kadaba. Kadaba means?
Lied.
Lied. Kadib?
Lied.
Haddathana Ali ibn al-Ja'ad. Qala akhbarna shu'ba. Qala akhbarni Mansur. Qala sami'atu ribi'iyya bin hirash. Yaqulu sami'atu aliyan yaqul. Qala nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. La takadibu aliyya. Fa innahu man kadaba aliyya fal yirjinnar. Narrated Ali radiallahu anhu. قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, لا تكذبوا علي. Don't tell a lie against me or upon me. فإنه suddenly he who من كذب علي suddenly he who lie upon me or lie against me. Who tells a lie? Whoever tells a lie against me. فليلجي النار. Let him enter the hellfire. Walaja means?
Endured.
Wulud. Endured. So, when we enter our house, we have to say one dhikr. Bismillahi waladina, wa bismillahi kharadina, wa ala rabbina.
Tawakkalna.
Yes. Bismillahi in the name of Allah. Waladina, we have endured. Wa bismillahi kharadina. And in the name of our Lord, in the name of Allah, kharajna, we went out. Wa ana rabbina, and upon our Lord, tawakkalna, we put all our trust. Or we entrust all our affairs. Okay. So walaja means entered. Falyali jinnar, let him enter the hellfire. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said. So falyali jinnara, here, بالولوج ولوج مسببا عن الكذب so, because of lying upon Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم that will become a cause to enter the hellfire. Okay. In another report it is there من يكذب علي يلجي النار. من يكذب علي, whoever tells a lie against me or upon me, then Yalijinnar. He will enter
Hellfire.
Okay. In another report, Al Kadibu Aliya Yulaju Yadakhulu Ayadakhulu Nar. Yulijinnar. Ayadakhulu Nar. The telling lie upon me will enter Hellfire. Or that Kadib. Telling lie upon Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam will be a cause to enter the hellfire, jahannam. Okay. Now next hadith. Hadith number 49. So from this hadith and its different reports, it is clear that the person who tells a lie upon the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam will enter the hellfire as a result of his lie upon Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Next hadith. Hadith number 49. حدثنا أبو الوليد قال حدثنا شعبة عن جامع بن شداد عن عامر بن عبد الله بن زبير عن أبيه قال قلت للزبير إني لا أسمعك تحدث عن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم كما يحدث فلان وفلان قال أما إني لم أفارقه ولكن سمعته يقول من كذب علي فليتبوأ مقعده من النار عن عامر بن عبد الله بن زبير عامر بن عبد الله بن زبير reports عن أبيه he reports from his father عبد الله بن زبير reports from his father قال he said قلت للزبير I asked Zubair what إني suddenly I لا أسمعك تحدث عن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم so I asked my Zubair asked Zubair means, I asked my father, who says, Abdullah. Ibn Zubair. Ibn Zubair means the son of Zubair. Yes? Son of Zubair. Qultu li Zubair. I asked Zubair. Means my father. Zubair, his father. So, this reported by Abdullah. Abdullah ibn Zubair. Zubair son Abdullah. Okay. So, I said to Zubair. Means, I said to my father. Inni la asma'uka tuhadithu an Rasulillah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I do not hear from you any narration of hadith of Allah's apostle, Allah's messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Kama yuhadithu fulanu ma fulan. Just as I hear from so and so persons, from so and so sahabas, companions of Allah's apostle or Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then, qala, he said, means Zubair said, it is Abdullah's father, Zubair radiallahu anhu, said in reply, replied, qala, ama inni la mufariquhu, you know, inni la mufariquhu, I didn't depart him, that is, I didn't depart Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I was always with him. I was, in most of the time, I was with Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Zubair replied, walakin, but, sami'atuhu yaqulu. Sami'a means?
Heard.
Sami'atu? I heard. Sami'atuhu, I heard him. Yaqul, saying, whom? Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So, Zubair replies to his son, Abdullah, that, why he is not reporting so much hadith from Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam just like some other sahabas? Why? Inni ama, you listen, you know, inni lam ufariquhu, I didn't depart him, that is, I didn't depart Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. I was always with him, or I was with him most of the time. Okay, then walakin, but sami'atuhu yaqul, I heard him say, this I heard Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam saying, man kadaba alayya, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, man kadaba alayya falyatabawwa maq'adahu min an-nar, whoever tells a lie against me, then let him occupy his seat in the hellfire. So I have heard him say like that. So I hesitate to report so much hadith. Okay, here in another report it is there, Mundu Aslamtu, or Qala Ama Inni La Mufariquhu Mundu Aslamtu, I didn't depart him since I embraced Islam. Still, I hesitate to report so much hadith because of the words of Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, that is, Man Kadaba Alayya فَلْيَتَبَوَّلْ مَقْعَدُهُ مِنَ النَّارِ. So, إِنِّ أَمَا means just listen, or just to take the attention of the person who is addressed. أَمَا, listen, or you know, like that. أَمَا إِنِّي لَمُفَارِقُهُ. So, it means I didn't depart him means, or I was always with him means, I was, or Zubair was, Zubair Allahu Anhu was with Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam most of the time. Okay. Mundu Aslam tu. Since he embraced Islam. Since I embraced Islam. Means since Zubair Allahu Anhu embraced Islam. He was with Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam most of the time. Then. In another report it is there. Man kadaba alayya mutha'ammid'an. Man kadaba alayya. Whoever tells a lie. Whoever told a lie, mutaammida, deliberately, mutaammida, deliberately, or intentionally, or willfully, deliberately, okay, then he will enter the hellfire. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, no. So Zubair son Abdullah asked his father why he reports lesser number of hadiths, why he is not reporting so many hadiths, or more number of hadiths from Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam when compared to some other sahaba, some other companions. Zubair radiallahu anhu replies that he didn't depart from the Prophet, but he was afraid of reporting too much because he heard the hadith from Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam where it says that whoever tells a lie upon him will enter the hellfire. And he didn't report the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, means he was with the prophets most of the time. Okay. Then this Zubair radiallahu anhu was a prominent companion of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He participated in the first hijra or migration to Habsha or Ethiopia. First hijra of Muslims to Ethiopia. It was to Habsha, the present Ethiopia. But he didn't take part in hijra to Al-Madinah with Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. No. فأما من أكثر منهم فمحمول على أنهم كانوا واثقين من أنفسهم بالتثبت أو طالت أعمارهم فاحتج إلى ما عندهم فسئلوا فلم يمكنهم الكتمان رضي الله عنهم. No, in Fatih al-Bari, you see, here we must understand the fact that those who reported too much hadith, some companions of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam reported too much hadith, or more hadith, more number of hadith from Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So they were also trustworthy persons. They were also good persons. Good Sahaba. Perhaps some of them might have lived for a longer time. Okay. So then they might have got a chance to report more. Okay. Then. And some of them might have feared concealing or khatman, concealing the hadith when they were asked about Prophet's hadith. So some people will ask the Sahaba about the hadith or the sunnah of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Then they were obliged to report it. The words and deeds of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So that's maybe the reason of reporting more and more. Okay, then. So hadith number 50. حدثنا أبو معمر قال حدثنا عبد الوارث عن عبد العزيز قال أنس أنه لم يمنعني أن أحدثكم حديثا كثيرا أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال من تعمد علي كذبا فليتبوأ مقعده من النار. No. Narrated Anas radiallahu anhu. The fact that annahu la yamna'uni, mana means stopped. La mani'a lima atait. After salah we say la mani'a. There is no one to stop or no one to prevent. No preventer is there. Lima atait, which you gave us, which you gave me. Okay. Then so annahu la yamna'uni, the fact which stops me, an uhadithakum hadithan kathira, from narrating a great number of hadith to you. That is, anna al-Nabiy sallallahu alayhi wa sallam qala. The reason is that Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, man ta'ammada alayya kadiban, whoever tells a lie against me intentionally or willfully or deliberately, one who tells a lie against me deliberately, intentionally, not forgetfully, or willfully, not unknowingly, deliberately, ta'ammada alayya kadiban, falyatabawwa maq'adahu min an-nar. Let him occupy his seat in the hellfire, his home, his abode in the hellfire. In another report of Imam Ahmad from Anas radiallahu anhu himself, there is, it is, لولا أني أخشى أن أخطاء لحدثتك بأشياء قالها رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. This Imam Ahmad radiallahu anhu records, rahmatullah alayhi, records one hadith from Anas radiallahu anhu where it says, if I didn't fear to err on myself or to have a mistake on myself in reporting hadith, I would have told you so many hadiths which the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had told. So hence it indicates that فأشار إلى أنه لا يحدث إلا ما تحققه ويترك ما يشك عليه. That is, it indicates that he reported, Anas radiallahu anhu reported what is confirmed, what is sure for him. He reported hadith of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam only what is sure to him. What was doubtful, he abandoned. He didn't report. Okay. He gave up what he doubted, whether it is from his memory. If he feels something doubtful about a report, about a hadith, then he will not report it. If he is confirmed, then only he will report it. Anas radiallahu anhu. Okay, follow. Then, so that's why he mentioned or reported lesser number of hadiths. So he feared sometimes, even if it is not deliberately, if any error or any mistakes happen in reporting hadith of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So that's why he kept a distance, or he reported lesser number of hadith, or he reported what is confirmed to him. Okay, what he doubted, he avoided. Okay, follow. Then now next hadith. حدثنا مكي بن إبراهيم قال حدثنا يزيد بن أبي عبيد عن سلمة قال سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول من يقول علي